Today I'm going to show you how to make this amazing jerk chicken dinner, and these are my ingredients for my jerk chicken marinade. I've made this before, but I don't mind showing it again. All ingredient measurements will be in my description box. If you already caught the first one, that's what's up. But let's get into it. So I'm just going to put all my ingredients into my mixer right here. That was my ginger, my scallions. I basically have thyme, I have lime juice, I have orange juice, I have soy sauce, I have brown sugar. The brown sugar is actually in the measuring cup with the orange juice on the bottom, which you're gonna see in a minute. I have garlic, I have everything, y'all. There it go, you see the sugar. Cause like, you know, y'all, I'm don't be trying to mess up a bunch of containers when I'm cooking. I try to keep it as simple and less as possible. So I had put it in the bottom and it dissolved a little bit. But you don't need a lot, it's only a couple tablespoons. Please don't kill this with sugar. That's not what we're trying to accomplish here. That was my apple cider vinegar. You can use the vinegar you have on hand. That was my soy and my oil. And this is my Scotch bonnet pepper sauce because I didn't have the actual peppers, so I used the pepper sauce and some liquid smoke. So I'm just going to add the lime juice and then we're going to blend this all the way down, and then you guys will see what that looks like. To my clean washed chicken, I'm gonna add the marinade right down over top. I'm probably gonna use half of this tub because I really want it to soak down in there. I have 4 leg quarters here and they're pretty big. Well, not pretty big, but they're big enough, they're not small. You want to set that to the side and allow it to marinate. And now I'm going to make the macaroni salad. This is my spicy girl. You can click the link below to purchase yours. And these are my other ingredients: sour cream, mayo, relish, mustard, scallions, cilantro, the works. Everything will be in my description box. So anyway, this is my roasted peppers, the one in a jar. If you're an overachiever like myself, you can make your own, but I'm using roasted peppers. Now, as far as this recipe is concerned, you guys, I'm basically doing it the way I want to and what I have available to me in my refrigerator, and that's what I did. Now, you might want eggs. You might not want the roasted red peppers. You might want celery. I didn't have that, so I used what was available to me. So I'm going to season this up with Spicy Girl salt and pepper. I'm going to mix it up, and then I'm going to add my tuna. And that's pretty much it for the salad. And that's going to be, this is going to be one of the sides for the chicken. This is what my husband wanted. You could, of course, put this with rice and peas, or some boiled dumpling, or some fried fritters, or festival. Whatever you want to put it with, that's fine. But this is what I'm making today, okay? So I'm going to mix this up, add the cilantro, and then I'm going to add the tuna like I just did. Mix it up, and that's it. Put it in the refrigerator. Let it do its thing while we work on the chicken. Alright, so now I'm going to put my chicken right on this rack like this. I'm doing this so that the heat can circulate on the bottom as well as the top. And I'm going to pop this into a 400 degree oven for 45 minutes. After 45 minutes, I'm going to check it and then you guys will see the next step. This right here is some butter that I'm melting down in this little pot. Just like this. This pot is tore up, y'all. I'm going to add a couple tablespoons of the jerk marinade to it. And I'm going to bring it to a boil and let it, you know, come to a boil for like 1 minute. And you're about to see what that looks like. It looks like this. And take it off the stove. You're not trying to cook it all the way. Just a minute. When I take the chicken out the oven after 45 minutes, this is what it looks like. Next, I'm going to pour some of the juices on the bottom of the pan in the same pot that has the melted butter with the 2 tablespoons of jerk marinade that we made earlier. And that's what I'm going to use to start basting the chicken. And at this point, I started to baste the chicken every 10 minutes until the internal temperature was 165 degrees. the juices from the pan, as well as the butter and the jerk marinade. And y'all, let me tell you something, don't you skip this step. Don't skip this step, because this step is very important. It looks so, so good. So this is my Misha's Corner Peach Please Barbecue Sauce. If you want to purchase this sauce, you can also click the link below. I'm going to add the sauce to the same exact pot that had the butter and the jerk marinade. And this is sort of just going to be on the side as a dipping sauce. You just want to heat this through for about 2 minutes, and that's pretty much it. This is my chicken right here, fresh out the oven, nice and charred and perfect. It is not burnt. This is how I like it, especially when I'm doing jerk. And I'm just gonna take my little cleaver and chop it up. I had to show that again. Y'all, I had so much fun making and preparing and prepping and putting this chicken together. It was just so much fun. And yeah, so this is what it looks like. That's the dipping sauce. And I'm gonna put it all together, plate it up, and let you guys see what everything looks like together. Now I'm just going to plate it up. This is my macaroni salad right here. It looks so good. It was so good, you guys, by the way. And this is actually my first time using the roasted red peppers in macaroni salad. But again, this is supermarket week and I used what I had, and that's just that. This is the beautiful, amazing chicken. This is my sauce, my warm sauce going right over the chicken. You don't want to bathe it in there. You don't want to glaze the whole thing. You just want to put enough, you know, because you still want people to taste the delicious chicken and all that work that you put into it. It doesn't need the sauce. It's not mandatory or a necessity. You just need to just put a little on there. That's it. Put a little on there, you're good. This is what the plate looks like. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for your support. Don't forget to hit the notification bell when you subscribe, and I'll catch you guys on my next video. Bye, y'all.